Now students, let us see this example. A fast moving cricket ball can throw away the stationary wicket. A fast moving bullet can pierce the human body, metal seats, etc. Running water can run turbine and produce electricity. And the blowing wind can be used to run the blades of a building. So from all these examples, it is clear that an object in motion has some energy. Okay, for example here, if you place a stationary ball near the wicket, then it will not throw out the wickets. But if the same ball is moving with a high velocity, then it acquires some energy so that it can apply the force on the stationary wicket and displace it. It means due to the motion, it acquired the capacity to do work on the wickets. Hence, we can say the moving ball acquired energy. In the same way, a fast moving bullet acquires energy such that it can pierce the human body as well as metal seats. Running water has the capacity to run the turbine, while the still water cannot run turbine and cannot produce the electricity. The blowing wind can run the blades of windmill, while the still wind or cannot run the blades of windmill. So all these examples clarify that an object in motion acquires some energy due to motion, such that it can do work on the other object. So the object which acquired the energy because of motion is known as kinetic energy. And hence we can define the kinetic energy as the energy possessed by an object due to motion. We can say kinetic energy, it is the energy possessed by the object due to its motion. Okay, so kinetic energy is the energy possessed by an object due to the motion. Okay, so if the kinetic energy depend on the motion of the object, then can we say kinetic energy depend on velocity? Because you know, if an object is in motion, then it has certain velocity. So can we say kinetic energy depends on velocity of the object? Or a fast moving object has more kinetic energy as compared to the relatively object which is moving slowly? Let us try to understand it, how the kinetic energy depends on velocity with the help of an activity. Now here in this activity, you can see that there is a trolley which is attached to a string, and this string is again attached to a pen here, okay, with the help of pulley. Now we place a block in between the trolley and pulley. Suppose here we place a weight W1. We place a weight W1. Then what we observe, when we place the weight W1 in the pan, then trolley starts moving with velocity V1. And when it starts moving with velocity V1, then it strikes the block P and apply a certain force F on the block P. Due to this force, the block P displaced from this position to here. Okay, let us say the displacement here is 10 centimeters. Okay, now let us observe the next situation. In the next situation also, you can see there is a trolley, the same trolley, which is attached with the same string to the same pan. And we have placed the same block in between the trolley and the pulley. Only the difference is that here we have placed the weight W1, but here we place two weights to increase the weight. Now let us see the total weight is W2. It is obvious that W2 is greater than W1. If the weight is increased, then the trolley starts moving with a greater velocity. Let us say in this case, the velocity is V2. Here, V2 is greater than V1. And when the trolley starts moving with a greater velocity, then it applies more force on the block B. Let us say here the block force is F dash. So here we can say that when the force F dash is applied on the block B due to this trolley, then in this case the block B displaced from here to here. Okay, let us say the displacement is 20 centimeters. Now observe carefully these two situations. In first situation you can see that when only W1 weight is placed, then trolley is moving with a velocity V1, due to which a force F is applied on the block and the block gets displaced by 10 cm. While when the weight is increased, then trolley starts moving with a velocity V2, which is greater than V1. And due to that greater velocity, a larger force is acted on the block B, due to which in this case the block is displaced by 20 cm, which is twice much large as in situation 1. So when we compare these two situations, so we can say that in situation 2 more work is done. More work is done due to more velocity. While here less work is done due to less velocity. So what we can conclude from this activity? We conclude from this activity that an object in motion possesses energy, and a faster moving object has more energy as compared to an object which is moving slowly relative to the previous object. Okay, so here we can write, first, a moving object possesses energy. Moving object possesses energy, and second thing is what? Faster moving object possesses more energy as compared to relatively slowly moving object. Faster moving object possesses more energy as compared to the object relatively moving slowly. Okay students, so these are the conclusions that we have drawn from this activity. Okay, now we will try to derive the expression for kinetic. Suppose students, there is an object of mass m which is initially at rest. Since it is initially at rest, then here It is placed on a smooth surface. Now what happened? We apply a constant force F on this object. Let this constant force be applied for a time t. Then what happened? In t time, it is displaced by a distance s and attains a velocity v. Okay. Initially the object was at rest. That's why we have written here u equals to 0. After that we apply a constant force F for some instant of time such that this object gets displaced by a distance s and attains a velocity v. Okay. Now it means we can say that because of the application of this force F, the object is displaced from the position A to the position B. Okay. Since some work is done, so we can write the work done, the work done by the force, by the force F is given by, you know, the formula for work done is W equals to F into S. Let us see this in the equation number 1. Now using the relation, V square minus V square equals to 2As. From here we can write S equals to V square minus V square upon 2A. Since in this case initially the object is at rest, that means u equals to 0. So here in place of u we can write 0. So this is equals to S equals to V square minus 0 square divided by 2A, or it is equals to V square by 2A. Okay students, so what we get here, we can write, let us see, we have S is equals to V square upon 2A. Let us see this equation number. Now again students, with the help of Newton's second law of motion, by Newton's second law, we know the force, net force F equals to mass of the object into acceleration. Let us see this in equation number 3. Now we are going to substitute equation 3 and equation 2 in equation 1. Then what we can write? From equation 1 we can write W is equal to F into S. Okay. So here W equal to F. In place of F, with the help of equation 3, we can write M into A, M into A into S. In place of S, we can write V square by 2A with the help of equation number 2. So here we have V square by 2A. Now A and A cancel out. So what we get? W is equal to half M V square. It means this is the amount of work done by the force F that we have applied. But students, when you observe carefully, then you can say that this force or this work done is utilized in increasing the velocity of the object from rest to V. Because if we have not applied this force, then the object will not attain velocity V. Because of the application of this force, some work is done. How much work is done? Half mv square. And this work is get utilized in increasing the velocity from rest to V. So we can say this work done is get stored in the form of kinetic energy in the object. So we can write as the work is done in increasing velocity from 0 to V. So kinetic energy of body is, we denote the kinetic energy by E and suffix K. So EK is equal to W, that is half MV. So we have the formula for kinetic energy, EK equals to half MV. This is the required formula for kinetic energy. Okay students, so this is the expression for kinetic energy, half mv square. This expression tells that the kinetic energy of an object directly proportional to its mass and also square of velocity. So this is the required expression for kinetic energy. Now we will understand the dependence of kinetic energy on the mass and velocity, and also draw the graph. Now we will see dependence of kinetic energy on mass. How the kinetic energy vary with mass of the object. So students, you know the relation for kinetic energy that we have derived, Ek equals to half mv square. Now we have to draw the graph between kinetic energy and mass, or we have to study the variation of kinetic energy with mass. Now students, you know how to plot a graph. Here we have to study the variation of kinetic energy with mass of object. Okay, so the quantity whose variation we have to study, we plot that quantity on y-axis. So here in this case we have to study the variation of kinetic energy, so kinetic energy should be plotted on y-axis. Why? The quantity with which we have to study the variation, is plotted on x-axis. So here we have to study the variation of kinetic energy with mass of the object. So mass is plotted on x-axis. So I hope it is clear. The quantity whose variation we have to see is plotted on y-axis, while with which we are observing the variation is plotted on x-axis. Okay. Now let us plot the graph. So here we have to plot the graph between kinetic energy and mass. So let us see velocity, a constant value. Assume that velocity equals to 2 meter per second. Okay. Let us assume the velocity as 2 meter per second. If v equals to 2 meter per second, then from this relation what we can write, Ek equals to half m into, in place of v square we can write v square, so it is equals to 4 by 2, that is 2 m. Okay, so what we get, Ek equals to 2 m. Now here we have mass and one is Ek. If you put m equals to 1, then what we get, Ek equals to 2 into 1, that is 2. If we put m equals to 2, then what we get, Ek equals to 2 into 2, that is 4. If you put here m equals to 3, then what we get? Ek equals to 2 into 3, that is 6. If you put m equals to 4, then ek equals to 2 into 4, that is 8. So we have the points corresponding to mass and ek. Ek is in joule and mass is in kilogram. Okay. Now let us plot the graph. So here we plot the graph. This is the y-axis and this is the x-axis. Okay, sir. Now on x-axis what we have to plot? Mass. So here we represent mass in kilograms. Okay. Let's say this is the 0, this is 1, 2, 3 and 4. Now on y-axis what we have to represent? Kinetic energy. So here let us say this is 2, 4, 6 and this is what? 8. This is 10. This is what? Ek in joule. Okay. Now plot the points. 1, mass to 1 and joule to 2. So here 1 and this is 2. So this is the point. Now when mass is 2, then energy is 4. So this is on mass. On x-axis, how we get 1, 2 and energy is 4. So this is 2 and this is 4. So this is the point. Again 3 and 6. So this is 3 and this is 6. 4 and 8. So this is 4 and this is 8 somewhere. Okay. Now we join all these points. Okay. So this is the nature of graph between the mass and kinetic energy. This graph shows that kinetic energy is directly proportional to mass. If we double the mass, kinetic energy will also get double. If we triple the mass, kinetic energy tripled. If we 4 times the mass, then kinetic energy will also becomes 4 times. So this is the relation or nature of graph between the kinetic energy and mass. Now we will see the dependence of kinetic energy on velocity. Dependence of kinetic energy on velocity. On velocity of the object. Now again students, we have the same relation. Ek equals to half mv square. Now here we have to study the variation of kinetic energy. So we plot kinetic energy on y-axis and we have to study the variation of kinetic energy with velocity. So we plot velocity on x-axis. Okay. Now let us plot. So this is the relation we have. Now let us suppose mass equals to 2 kg. M equals to 2 kg. So if you put 2 kg here, then what we get? Ek equals to half into, in place of M, 2 into V square. So it is equals to 2 and 2 cancel out. So what we get? V square. That is what we have. Ek equals to V square. Okay. Now let us take the values. Here we have velocity meter per second and ek in joule. If we put velocity 1 meter per second, 1 meter per second, then what we get? Ek equals to square of 1, that is 1. If we put 2 meter per second in place of v, then what we get? Ek equals to 2 square means 4. If we place 3 in place of velocity, then what you get? Vk equals to 3 square minutes 9. If you place v equals to 4 meter per second, then Ek equals to 4 square minutes 16. Okay, students. So we have the corresponding points. Now we plot the graph. So this is the y-axis. Okay. And this is the x-axis. Now in this case, on x-axis, what we represent? Velocity. So on x-axis, we represent velocity in meter per second. And on y-axis, what we represent? Kinetic energy in joules. Okay. This is the zero. Now, let us say this is 1, this is 2, this is 3, and this is 4, this is 5, okay? And on here, this is on y-axis, what we have to plot these points. So let us say this is 4, okay? This is 8, this is 12, 16, 20. Okay, students. Now let us plot. When velocity is 1 meter per second, then 1 joule of energy. So this is 1, this is 4, so at somewhere here, this is 2, and this is 1. So we have the corresponding point here. Okay. Now, at 2, the velocity is, the energy is 4 meter, 4 joule. So this is 2, and the energy is this much, 4 joule. Now, at 3, we have 9 joule. So we travel 3, 1, 2, 3 on x axis, and 9 on y. So this is 8, and this is somewhere 9. This is the point. Now at 4, the energy is 16. So we travel 4 on x axis, 1, 2, 3, 4, and then 16 on y. So this is somewhere here. Okay, so this is the 4 system. Now join all these points, then what we get? This is the relation, this is the nature of graph between the velocity and kinetic energy. Okay, students? This is the nature of graph between velocity and kinetic energy. Or you can say the kinetic energy is proportional to the square of velocity. What does it mean? If we double the velocity, then kinetic energy will become 4 times square of 2. If we triple the velocity, then kinetic energy becomes square of 3, means 9 times. If we 4 times the velocity, then kinetic energy will become square of 4, that is 16 times. So this is the relation or dependence between kinetic energy and velocity of the object. Okay, students? Now, students, there is a relationship between momentum of an object and kinetic energy of an object. Suppose there is an object of mass M. There is an object of mass M which is moving with a velocity V. Okay? Since it has mass and velocity, so it must have momentum, because you know momentum is the product of mass and velocity. Let us say the momentum is P. Then what we can write? P equals to M into V. Let us say this is the equation number 1. Again, students, you know the kinetic energy also depends on mass and velocity. You know, kinetic energy is given by half mv square, which depends on mass and velocity. So if this object has mass and velocity, then it must have kinetic energy. Let us say the kinetic energy be Ek. So we can write kinetic energy Ek equals to half mv square. Okay. If we multiply this expression, that is half mv square, by m, and also divide by e, then what we can write? Half mv square into m divided by m. I hope this will not affect this expression half mv square. Okay. Now half mv square into m, what we get? M square v square divided by 2 into m. ओके एम स्क्वायर बी स्क्वायर कैन बी रिटन एज एम बी स्क्वायर डिवाइड बाय 2m. बट व्हाट इज एम बी मास इनटू वेलोसिटी मास इनटू वेलोसिटी अकॉर्डिंग टू इक्वेशन 1 इज व्हाट मोमेंटम सो हियर वी कैन राइट p स्क्वायर बाय 2m व्हाई सिंस momentum is equal to mass into velocity. So in place of m into v, what we can write? P. So here we have kinetic energy Ek equals to p square by 2m. This is the relation between kinetic energy of an object and momentum of the same object. Okay? Again, this expression can be rearranged as see. What we get? Ek equals to p square by 2m. Okay, so from here we can write p square is equal to 2m into Ek or p equals to square root of 2m Ek. So this is one more relation. Students, all you have to note down in your notebook and you have to make the proper notes with the help of the things that I have written on this board. Okay. I am not going to provide you separate notes. You must have to prepare the notes along with the class. Okay. So that's it for this for today. Now in the next class we will see some more relations and also about potential.